and worse. What were they doing here?
Take you.
Thank you.
damn thing. It has to open, surely. It has to do something.
Shadowheart's attention is consumed by a strange box that she turns over in her hands. The box is inscribed with unfamiliar glyphs. In an instant, Shadowheart hides the box from view.
Keep out of it. A bold statement, if not an accurate one. Leave me be.
Scratch's tail wags enthusiastically. Scratch's tongue lolls out happily, his tail wagging even faster.
Something the matter? You already know my biggest secrets. What more can you ask? She took me in when no one else would. Without her, I wouldn't be alive. She's my mother. She nurtures me, cares for me, loves me. Don't believe the lies the Saloonites tell. There's no story. None that you're entitled to hear, anyway. Just forget you ever saw it. I don't have to explain myself to you. There's potential in you. Let's see how you handle this. I am indeed a disciple of Shah, Mistress of the Night and Lady of Loss. I assume you've heard of her. My Lady Shah is the Night Singer, the patron of darkness and loss. Most fear the dark, like children, because in darkness they see their fears reflected. But Shah teaches us to step beyond fear, beyond loss. In darkness, we do not hide. We act. Pain, hope, the promise of better days. All of these are heavy cloaks that bend our backs and burden our hearts. We shed those cloaks. Before Shah, we stand gloriously naked, beyond the vanities of mortals. Tear down the lies the world is drunk on. The institutions they trust, the so-called gods they worship, the lives they cling to. We destroy false idols, topple corrupt organizations, fight heretics wherever they're found. There's often suffering, death even. Many people break before they embrace Shah's truths. You're wiser than most. Many people balk at our doctrine. It's the reason why we cherish secrecy. You surprise me. And not in a negative sense, I must admit. Perhaps once we've saved ourselves from the tadpoles, we can talk more on this.
Ah, there you are. How did you enjoy my deer stew this evening?
It's an old family recipe.
Good. I tend to season it with spices from Karatur, but given what's available to us, good old Rosemary had to see us through. Not that I mean to regale you with my culinary exploits. There's actually something quite different I'd like to discuss. Indirectly, yes. We've been traveling together for a while now. And during those travels, I've been observing you. I want you to know that I like what I see. The way you stood in front of a crossbow to prevent a murder. The way you got Korga to release the girl. The way we got that boy out of a harpy's clutches. The way you followed the protocol and brought me back to life. In short, I've grown to trust you. Now I need you to place your trust in me. Our journey together is bound to last a while still. As such, I feel compelled to speak. I say this because there's something I desperately need. But while I'll tell you what that something is, I won't tell you why. I have to ask you to agree to this before carrying on this conversation.
You become one with Gale's mind, and you can feel something sinister oppressing you. It's inside of you, a mighty darkness radiating from your chest. You could try to push further, but your hold over Gale feels brittle. It won't be easy delving deeper without him noticing.
You're using the tadpole against me. This is a breach of trust that... I think I thought you trustworthy in the first place. I'm leaving. I cannot stand to be around such betrayal a moment longer. That is a lie and you know it. This is where we part ways.
Strahd's body is crushed. Must have fallen from the eye. Something over there.
Damn! Some of these mushrooms are illusions. ocean. Is anything real down here?
That again.
A chill runs up your spine. You feel like you're being watched. Has a quiet sense of calm. You can't see anything strange.
Oh!
I don't want a crumb left on that plate, girl.
Auntie Ethel, please. One more bite and this pie is going to come back up to say hello.
Don't make me get the wooden spoon. You're eating for two, so get to it. Who is this? A friend of yours?
No, I don't know her.
Come now. Aren't you going to introduce yourself? Oh, I like you. You may stay. Feel free to relax yourself and have a cuppa, Gods grant me patience. Eat up, Mayrina. I won't say it again. Beautiful, isn't it? It's my little refuge for the lost and hopeless. People in dire need travel from all over Faerûn to see little old me, and I do my damnedest to help them. And you, Petal, well, you need a lot of help. That wriggler swimming in your brain juice is a bit of an inconvenience, isn't it? Because you stink. And I know the stench of Mind Flayer anywhere. I can tell you're almost done cooking. You know, you could turn just like that. What do you say? Want me to take care of the little bugger? I do like them eager. But know that I don't work for free. I expect payment up front. One of your pretty little peepers. I'll pluck it from your head. Kiss it for luck. Then back in it goes. Won't take but a moment. That is my price. Nothing more, nothing less. I'm afraid that's my business, Petal. It's nothing nefarious, though. I promise. A touch, but sure you've two eyes in your skull, don't you? No need to be precious. Quiet, you've had enough pampering. And you, my door is always open, Petal. Auntie Ethel is here for you.
can just walk into rooms now. This gets better and better.
Ah, stranger. Forgive the aroma.
You catch a waft of something foul, metallic, and sickly sweet.
Powdered iron vine. An old hunter's trick. Most monsters will think twice before making a meal of me.
You're a monster hunter. I'm surprised. I thought all Ger were vagrant cutthroats.
And more. We steal chickens, curse your crops, seduce your daughters, the list goes on. Now, I wish I had half the power settled folk think my people possess. Alas, I am a simple wanderer. A simple wanderer and monster hunter. But I'm no witch doctor or cutthroat.
Something terrifying, no doubt. Dragon? Cyclops?
Nothing so dramatic. I'm hunting for a vampire spawn. His name is Astarion, but I fear he's gone to ground. I hope the hag of these lands can help me flush him out, if I can afford her blood price.
I don't know. I'm sure a vampire spawn could still rip out your throat if he felt like it.
He is right, unfortunately. They are only weak when compared to their masters. During the day, we have the advantage. But at night, when they hunt, you'll not find a more deadly quarry. That's a Starion. No. Impossible.
These days, I'm making the impossible look easy. May I? Excellent.
A vampire? It can't be.
Morse, cut!
Thank you.
Given your own nature, are you really the one to judge?
That might be worth a look. Thank you.
Scratch's tail wags enthusiastically. Scratch's tongue lolls out happily, his tail wagging even faster.
what you need now.
With the leadership dead, no attack will be mounted on the Grove. I am in your debt, my friend. Speak to Rath. He will reward you for your efforts. Soon. First, I must set matters to rights in the Grove. And you should celebrate your victory. After being dormant for so long, your infection is unlikely to produce new symptoms spontaneously. Tomorrow morning, we shall discuss what is to come. Then go forth. There are no easy paths to what you seek. If you seek my aid, you must show patience. Yes, you did. You acted according to your instincts, to nature. This is my fault. I was not here to guide them. Now they rest forever, while I carry the weight of my failings. But the Grove still stands, even if they do not, thanks to you. Rest, heal, celebrate if you wish. Mourn if you must. Come morning, we shall discuss delivering you from your parasite.
Scout just reported. The Goblin's leadership has been decimated. We might escape this place yet. I took a collection from all of us. It isn't much, but you've earned it. It's not enough, but it's all we have. We have put our lives on hold long enough. Just a little longer now, thankfully. But perhaps we need not speak of farewells. We'll join your camp tonight to celebrate if you'll have us. My people are ready to leave when you are. Just give the word.
Grab your bags. We're moving.
Done it. You brought Hulsun back. Thank you.
No, thanks is not enough. May Sylvanas bless you for all your days. I cannot imagine taking on a camp full of goblins was a simple task. Fair enough. I should not have underestimated you. And I promised you a reward, didn't I? Let me show you on your map where you can find the cache. Take this. You'll need it.